Tell me this. What was the situation or the person, if you want to say it like that, however you want to answer it is fine, that really grew you the most? If you would ask me, I would candidly say it was my divorce. I'll tell you that. And it was that was tough. And going through that was a lot. And whatever immaturity I had, I would say 75% of it was ranched off by that time. Right. But you still got, you know, a little left. But what was it for you?
You opened the door just now. I just went through a divorce, and it was really rough. Okay. It was rough because it wasn't cheating on the wife or the wife cheating on me. Sure. We were just in a place of not standing on the same platform. She's an amazing woman. Mm. We have three baby daughters. Well, the 15-year-old is like her dad. She's gone off to college already. Wow. But that was one of the roughest times of my life. And here's why. We came to a great understanding, but what people don't understand is when the lawyers get involved, it just changes the game. And to hear the lawyer making comments about my ministry, he's only given because he's hiding millions, and, you know, all of the garbage, you know. And you have to be there for these babies. Wow, you've got to smile and be strengthened. And this is the first time I've even revealed this anywhere. But what made me be honest about it today was you said something that I really know that many folk don't ever say. It still grew me up. I thought I was mature already. Yeah, I thought I had everything in line. But it grew me up spiritually too. Because you still have to look in the faces of the people of God that say, you know everything. He's our pastor. He's our pastor. So for 2 years, we said nothing. We said nothing. It was only 6 months ago, maybe, or sooner, that I really revealed what really happened. Yeah. But here's the maturity. To be able to walk worthy of your call in the midst of adversity. Mm. I need people to understand. Come on, and when I tell you this, Peach is a wonderful woman of God, and I celebrate her even now. And it's just strange because the turmoil and all of the stuff people think you go through at the end of
their
Well, and that was the issue, because you heard all kinds of things, you know, but we have to be mature enough to understand. We still have to maintain these babies. I had the boys. They were older. She had the babies. They were younger. But in it all, even the other day, I don't know if you know, socially, I made a joke last week, which I shouldn't have done. I said, I found my boo in Florida. And I posted it, and I said, I'm going to show you who she is in 2 days. It was a 90-year-old lady that I met. Yeah, Mother Hughley. Y'all, she was so gorgeous. She came to the after party both nights.
Wait a minute.
Yes.
Come on.
And she had little quirks and things she would say that just would make me laugh. She told me, now, you know you need to hook up with me. I'll show you how to cut a chicken right.
Uh-huh.
I don't even know what that means.
You want to cut that chicken. I know that.
But cutting that chicken at 90 was just gorgeous. Well, I put it on social media. Social media went crazy.
Wow, man.
People thought I was introducing a new girlfriend. It started digging up. Folk was done. But it just shows you at some point you have to have a life. And I tell them, now, don't sleep on me now, because I'm going to be happy again.
Yeah.
You know. But we have to understand at the end of the day. That's a great question, because I get it. I don't know how many people get it, but it matures you in a way that nothing else can. So, and I just thank God that he's covered us to a place where we are going to take care of these babies and do right by.